to it. Many have noted that McCain last night, John McCain, never looked at your husband during the first debate. There's a lot of buzz about this moment especially. Let's watch.
It was an energy bill on the floor of the Senate, loaded down with goodies, billions for the oil companies. And it was sponsored by Bush and Cheney. You know who voted for it? Might never know. That one. You know who voted against it? Me.
Did you take offense to that one?
No. I mean, you know,
people are talking about it.
Well, you know, I think there are two conversations that have been going on throughout this whole election. There's the conversation that's been happening with the pundits and, you know, the polls, and then there's the conversation that's been happening on the ground. And the folks out there right now are scared. They're nervous about the economy. They don't care about the sort of back and forth between the candidates. They want real answers about how we're going to, you know, fix this economy and get the healthcare benefits back on track. So, you know, this is part of politics.
How people phrase things. So you think it's the pundits that are more interested in that term?
That's my sense of it. You know, I mean, I have traveled around this country. I was in a few states just in the last day and a half, and no one asks about this kind of stuff. I mean, they want to know about the positions that the candidates have on the issues. You know, what are we going to do with this war? How are we going to get our education system on track? And people really want to understand, you know, how this economy is going to really affect their bottom line.
Did it in any way offend you?
No. I have to say that, you know, in these debates, I am so focused on what Barack is saying, you know, and how he's, you know, phrasing his words. And I'm really trying to listen to the substance of what he's saying to make sure that I understand what's going on, that these little, you know, sound bites don't register with me. A lot of times I'm looking around at the face of the undecided voters in the room. I'm trying to see how they're reacting. So there's so much going on in a room that a phrase here or there just doesn't, you know, it just doesn't resonate.
Do these two candidates, as has been reported, not like each other?
I can only speak for Barack, and I know that Barack has the utmost respect for Senator McCain. He's said so on so many occasions. You know, I think this has been a long, tough fight, and politics sometimes leads to things said between the candidates. But again, what we found is that people are really focused on who's got the vision that's going to take us to the next level.
Your husband appears so cool, though. Doesn't he get angry?
Yeah, he gets angry, but he doesn't get angry about this stuff. I mean, what you heard in that debate, when you saw his passion, it was when he was talking about the healthcare crisis, and he talked about his mother dying of ovarian cancer, and how angry it made him to see her worrying about the insurance company and the payments rather than worrying about getting well. And that's what we're seeing. That's the kind of stuff that makes Barack angry. It's not the back and forth. It's not something said about him. I think Barack said today he can take, you know, any name calling or the back and forth that, you know, that stuff doesn't bother him. But the unfairness that we're seeing across the country, that makes him mad.